Hi everyone, so today I'll be doing draw my life tag, and while doing this tag I relived emotions like fear, guilt, love, envy, hope, just to name a few. So I was born on 9th June 1988 in the city of Lakes, Bhopal, which is the capital of Madhya Pradesh. Dad, who is my role model, and he is a very hardworking and dedicated person. I wish I had at least half of his qualities. My mom is a perfect and beautiful homemaker, great mom, and my very first teacher. I had a 6-year elder sister who I always admired since my childhood. Perfect example of beauty with brains, and my family always wanted me to be just like her. I was born with blue eyes. Most of you won't believe me, but someone with light eyes would understand what I'm saying. Eyes do change its color. What my mother and sister told me, and also from my faded memories, I know that I was quite a famous kid in my colony. I would talk to anyone and everyone and invite them to my place. I was flamboyant, outgoing, and a happy kid, and not to forget, I was a big mouth. My mom was always scared about the words that might come out of my silly little mouth, and I clearly remember the countless number of times I got into trouble at home for talking or playing with certain people my parents didn't approve of. Ever since I was a child, I hated being at home. I used to stare at the park from my window, waiting for the clock to strike 6. I started going to school when I was 3 years old, and I had to change 5 schools in total, which is quite a lot for me. I was always inclined towards craft and art, and my less attentive nature and disability to concentrate and sit still for a longer period of time used to infuriate my dad, and he used to get really angry whenever he used to help me with my studies. I joined St. Joseph Coed School in 1994 in first standard. As far as I can remember, I met my first best friend Charu in the school, and we used to be together all the time. When I was 6 years old, I became an elder sister. I got the cutest gift from my parents, my baby brother. He was just so cute and huggable, with dark curly hair and big eyes. I was obsessed with my baby brother. He was just the cutest thing I ever saw. I used to talk to almost everyone. I was very talkative and I loved to play. I had a really cute boy in my class in second standard, and our teachers made us sit together. I clearly remember how much I used to trouble him. I used to make partition on my table. He was quite shy and we used to fight a lot. I kind of feel bad about it now, but we gradually became friends. The next year he left school and I had no clue where he went, and slowly I forgot about him. I was just a kid. So in school I was an average student, and teacher used to like me. I never did my holiday homework during the holidays. It was all done in 1 week before reopening of the school. In my parents and teacher meeting, I always used to get similar remarks like good student but very talkative, good in extracurricular activities, should pay attention in class. I had my worst year of my schooling life in fourth standard. We had a very strict teacher, and she used to beat the crap out of students, and I was scared to get my work checked, and I used to hide my notebooks, and my sister and mom helped me with my studies. I was kind of tomboyish in school. Following years were amazing. I did well in academics. I was in school band. I played flute in the band with a group of girls in the morning assembly. Lorenzo, who is no more now, was the only one who used to manage the whole band. He was the best teacher I ever had, being one of his favorite students, and he always encouraged me to be confident, as I used to feel shy standing in the front row just behind the mic leading the band. One single mistake and the whole band would sound terrible. I also learned classical dance in school, and I remember during one performance I was standing in the front on stage, and one of my teachers stood just in front of me below my stage just to remind me that I have to smile. I gave her a really bad time during practices. I even played basketball for my house. So let's just fast forward my life a little bit, and in my 7th standard I met my best friend, who is still my best friend. She is more than a friend, like a sister to me, Pratishtha, and we met over a science project, and she was fun, confident and mature. and we used to talk for hours and hours and hours, and both our parents used to get really angry. Like, ever since I was a child, I was very emotionally sensitive. On the other hand, my family is like any other typical Indian family, very introvert, and I was very demonstrative and expressive. So basically, during my growing years, I had problems understanding them, and I thought they don't love me, of which I think now, and I feel silly now. During that time, I never got along with my elder sister. We are poles apart, and she was a strict elder sister. I miss the most about Bhopal was Holi. It used to be my favorite festival. We used to hide on terrace and throw balloons on boys. Once I accidentally threw a bucket full of water on a group of boys. Thank God no one was hurt. To sum up my life in Bhopal, which is very difficult, I had the best time of my life. But my life changed. I had to leave Bhopal, my house, my playground, my friends, everyone. And I had to leave Bhopal and shift to Kanpur. I cried all the way till airport, even on the plane, even after reaching there. It was very difficult for me. I cried for days. And then I got used to it. It was a completely different environment. It was loud, but it was dirty, and we used to have frequent power cuts. People were different. It was a big change for me in my growing years. In short, I hated the place. The only pleasant memories I have about that place are of my school and my friends. I met the sweetest girl in that school. Everyone was so down to earth and polite, and we had so much fun, and I still treasure the time I spent with all my girlies. In Kanpur, I was really scared to travel alone. We used to commute by human rickshaw, and I was stalked for months. I ended up seeing a wrong guy because of my insecurities and loneliness and fear. I won't go into details in this video. Let's keep this video positive. The majority of my friends were momdin, and they all used to wear suits. So I spent my entire life in salwar suit basically. It's a big change for a tomboyish girl to get all feminine in Kanpur. But soon that place turned out to be inauspicious for us. We encountered chain of unfortunate events. My sister, who was living with our joint family in other state for her studies, we got a call from my uncle that she has been admitted to the hospital. After reaching there, we got to know that her right side was paralyzed. We were at the point where we could have lost her forever. But slowly she started recovering, and soon after that incident, we lost my dad's eldest brother in very unpleasant circumstances. My bad company completely changed me as a person. I started lying to my parents, and the creative side of me died. I was no more the old, happy, lively deeptima. My dad, after these two incidents, decided to shift to Delhi so that my sister would continue her studies and treatment with us in the new city. Again, a different city. This time it was Delhi, and I was again the new girl, but this time I had difficulties making new friends and in trusting them. To keep things to the point, I met the meanest and most selfish people here. Nothing against Delhiites. I love Delhi. I met so many good people also in Delhi, and I'm still in contact with them, but most of them just gave me bad memories, and I don't even want to talk about it. I didn't have anyone by my side, and I was lonely again. I was a simple girl for Delhi's lifestyle. People used me for their own good, lied about things I never said. I always got attention, but I never found a true friend. I was still in contact with my Bhopal friends via letters, because Facebook was just I guess Facebook had just taken birth, or it was still non-existent. That guy I was seeing was really insecure. He didn't like me talking to boys or me making new friends, so I was basically lonely and depressed and sad. I used to cry behind locked doors, and I had no one on my side. I had no friends, like real friends. I was unhappy, and I wanted someone to understand me. I wanted a friend. I wanted freedom. I wanted to live my life on my own terms. Because of all these tensions and stupidities going on in my life, I became really rebellious, and my relationship with my mom and family were getting affected by it. In 2006, I finished my school, and I also lost my grandmother while I was having my 12th boards. Again, I didn't even get a chance to say final goodbyes to her or to see her in her last days. Maybe that's the reason I fear of losing my loved ones. Moving on, time for graduation. Yay! Feeling all grown up and big and mature. I wanted to go in a creative field, maybe fashion designing, interior designing, maybe animation, but my dad didn't see a future in it. So he enrolled me in DU, that's Delhi University, for Bachelor of Art program. It was a 3-year course. I studied economics, mass communication, political science, philosophy, and all that subjects. My first day was not as expected. It was actually horrible. Like, again, I cried at home, different people, and I thought I would never be able to make friends in college. But I made some really nice friends in my college, and it was really fun in the initial years. I met so many new people, and I was seeing the same guy, and because of him I ruined my relationship with a very good friend. Let's name her S for the video. And although things got sorted out later on, but they never got back to normal. See how bad decisions lead to a bad life. Not blaming anyone, it was all my fault. For some reason I didn't get along with the females. I always felt boys were better friends. During this time I was still seeing that old guy, and things were getting a little out of control. I wanted to be free, but I was scared. I would advise anyone who's in a bad relationship to just believe in yourself and don't let other people take charge of your life. During this time God heard me, and I was active on Orkut. I hope some of you might remember Orkut. And I got a message from a guy who I knew from my childhood, and he was the same boy I used to play with in second standard. And you might know this guy, his name is Sumit. All thanks to Orkut, I found such a good friend and a great human being. My life changed. I finally found someone who understood me, someone who saw the pain in my eyes, and he made me realize my worth. After many years, I felt good about myself. I was happy from inside. He came to know about what I was going through, and I found strength to stand up against all the shit I was getting in the name of relationship. I hit a point in my life where I decided that I couldn't take it anymore. I ended the ruined relationship and I told my family about it, and they stood by me. It was all a huge mess, and I overcame everything because I had the support of my family and my best friend Sumit. I was again the happy Deeptima. I got involved in many activities. In college, I got into politics. I was a dummy candidate for elections. I became a campus RJ, but just the name was fancy. I quit the offer during the first year of my college. I also worked in a consultancy and realized that I cannot work under pressure and a boss. Moreover, the owner was not a nice person. I felt really uncomfortable with all the strange attention and concern. So I left the job within a month. If I go into detail, the video would like never end, so I'll save up few things for my future videos. He helped me find the real me, helped me to get back my lost confidence. He taught me to love myself, and above everything else, he got me closer to my family. During this phase, I started painting again, did DIY projects, and one day while I was searching for some DIY ideas, I stumbled upon Threadbanger, and I got introduced to YouTube. I was beyond happy. I started doing things that made me happy. I used to watch aunt beads, yeah, and other jewelry making tutorials. One day I decided to look up on the internet for some makeup ideas for green eyes, and I came across Lauren Luke, my first ever makeup video on YouTube, and that changed everything. I even started posting random stupid videos of handmade jewelry, of dogs, my cousin, baby sister, and I never thought about it. After my college, we were doubtful about my dad's another transfer, but I didn't want to leave Delhi now, so and I decided to enroll myself in Business System Information Management course in NIIT, as I thought job after this course was the only chance to stay in Delhi. I really had high hopes, but the institute and the course turned out to be a total waste of time and money. We didn't get qualified teachers. By the time I was getting more and more involved in makeup, and I was questioning myself where this course will take me. Do I really want to do this? Do I really wish to have regular job? And then I got paid from YouTube. I could not believe that I made money from a hobby out of something that I myself was learning from YouTube. People started writing to me for their makeup queries and how they enjoyed watching me. In 2011, I decided to be a YouTuber. Slowly I learned the art of makeup, and slowly I'm trying to improve my work and presentation with the available resources. My love for makeup kept growing ever since, and now I have a big dream to be a makeup artist. I found another way to express myself in a creative way, by makeup. I always strive for perfection, but in the current scenario, I have few limitations. My dream of being a good makeup artist and to produce better videos have to wait a little longer. To give in my 100%, I have to wait till I move into my own house. And so finally, I want to thank all of you who watch my videos, or even if you're watching my video for the first time, I want to thank you all, because you have touched my life in a very special way. In the end, I would just say, stay tuned, because my story has just begun.